Well, hello and welcome everyone to yet another video from Board Infinity. So if you are someone who is looking for a transition into data science, if you are someone who is soon going to appear for your interviews, well, there are two things that you should necessarily have. One, the skills required for the job, and second, a platform where you can showcase your skills. Well, my friends, the good thing is that LinkedIn is there for you. LinkedIn is a platform where you can not only, you know, showcase your skills in terms of projects, in terms of your certifications, you can also connect with the industry experts and show them your portfolio. You can also directly get access to tons and tons of opportunities in terms of jobs and internships, and you can get directly connected with the recruiters as well. And the vice versa too, the recruiters can reach out to you as well if you have a good skills, if you have a good LinkedIn profile. So with that being said, we have arranged this session for you to help you with your journey, and you're going to learn how to make an effective LinkedIn profile and how you can, you know, get started with your job hunt. With that being said, this session will be taken by our coach Piyush sir, who will be telling you the nuances of LinkedIn. So with that said, I wish you a great career ahead and you can enjoy the session.
So hello everyone, my name is Piyush and I am a senior data scientist working with Accenture AI, and I am in this field from past couple of years. I have been worked with various verticals like sales, retail, marketing, healthcare, human capital as well. So today we will understand a very important agenda, right? Today we will cover a very important agenda, like why LinkedIn is important and why we have to make a good portfolio in the LinkedIn. Why every recruiters, they are preferring to check your LinkedIn portfolio first before maybe like starting with your interview or something. So today I'll basically segregate this whole video into a three part. Like first here, like I will give you the idea of three main important thing here, right? Why LinkedIn is so I have divided this video into three categories. Like first, that how to build a good LinkedIn portfolio and why it is important, right? This is the first part which I am going to cover in the next 15 minutes. Then the second part which I will cover, that is the how to post and publish any kind of post which you want to publish here, right? In order to reach a maximum reach or visibility. And I will also tell you in this manner that how to grow the connections, how to make more new connections, how to check is are the connections are required for you or not. Then the third part is actually like how to increase your visibility in the LinkedIn. How to reach maximum people, how to reach to the recruiter, how to like apply in the job as well, right? This all I will cover in today's session. Okay, so I'll start with my profile first. So like, yeah, before jumping to the LinkedIn profile, I would like to tell you that why LinkedIn is important. So nowadays, like LinkedIn is a place where you have created your each and everything, right? You have put your resume, you have put your educational background, you have put your professional background, you have put your projects, you have put your skills, your hobbies, each and everything you have put. Along with that, the industry people, they can also check your they can also check your engagement, right? Are you engaging with the right persons or not, or are you just doing your activity, that's it? You are just building your portfolio for showing that portfolio to the recruiters as well, or only. So I'll start with my portfolio, right? So my name is Piyush Patak, as I mentioned. So this is my LinkedIn, where I have so while building the LinkedIn, right, we have to focus on some of the key features, right? That we have to put our a project very well, we have to define and we have to describe our project very well, we have to put our educational background, we have to put if we have some kind of achievement, then we have to showcase here. The main important part of figuring out all this stuff and showing all this stuff is to maintain a good keywords or a good set of keywords, which is very important. So whenever you are creating your LinkedIn, we just need to go to the LinkedIn and do the sign up, right? And at that time, doing the sign up, you just need to upload your like I'm not jumping to the basics of the LinkedIn, right? That how to upload your image, how to upload your like resume and all. I just tell you that how to make it more and more better, so that more number of people, they can reach you, they can come to you for maybe for some kind of work, maybe for some kind of job you can get, right? So LinkedIn is a very good platform, and most of the recruiters, they prefer to check the LinkedIn first. And we have so many functionality here, like we have a home button, we have a mic networks, where we have a multiple number of networks are there, maybe our network connections as well, maybe a request as well. Then we have a jobs, like some ongoing jobs, some new vacancies you can directly check from here, and you can directly apply. So that this thing we also check here. Then we have a message sections, where we got so many messages from the various connections. Then we have notifications, then the simple your settings at all. So now I'm considering that people already created that their basic LinkedIn profile, right? They have uploaded their image, they have uploaded their resume, maybe they have uploaded some of the basic information. That's it. Now the main important part is actually started with your introduction, the first page, right? Where we have our name, along with the name we have some kind of text. So here I'm just putting some text, so whatever I'm working on, like I'm a senior data scientist, I have done some kind of research task in machine learning and the deep learning. I'm also a mentor, I'm a consultant, I'm providing some business intelligence and the strategies to the different buyers and the clients. And then I'm also doing some kind of influence, so that's why I have put these kind of keywords here. Then I am in this Gurgaon location, so I have put that. Then my company name is here, then my educational last education I have put here, right? Now post that, what you need to do, you need to provide a very very good about, right? Where the whole history of your, you need to present that, how many years of experience you have. If you have more than 4 years of experience, or if you are a proficient, or you are a proficient in any area, then you can showcase in this way. Otherwise, if you've done any kind of a mini project or something, then you can also showcase here, right? Now along with that, what you need to do, you need to provide a very good introduction here, right? Where we have, like I have put, like I have worked in various or pivotal roles that required a simplifying and the business functions and all, right? So you just need to put your simple introduction here. Then if you want, then you can also, like, yeah, so I also mentored 50 plus professionals, so I have mentioned here. Then you can put here your skills if you want. Then you can also put, like, I know these so many skills, I have worked on various analytical tools as well, I have knowledge of some databases, I have some knowledge of big data tools, I have some knowledge of visualization tool or BI tools, I have some knowledge of web scraping, APIs, API deployment tool as well, some cloud model deployment tool, some chatbots, some containerization techniques, then some web-based version controllers like Bitbucket and all. So these all skills I know, right? So that's why I put here. And if you have your portfolio, you have created your portfolio in any kind of site, maybe in the Heroku platform or maybe other platform, or maybe you have your own website, then you can also put your website here for that detailed informations. Now this is not important part if your visibility is not much so far, but yeah, I have done some great job. I have shared one all automated machine learning libraries, and my this GitHub is actually featured by the Chris Nayak. So I have put this in the featured button, where I have some kind of some posts are here, like 2 or 4 posts are here, right, which I have put here. So you can also put if you want. Now post that this is the area, this is the pane where we have our activities. We have done so many activities, like I am posting various data science related helping cheat sheets and other stuff on daily basis. So all this you will find here. Now the important part is started from here. The second phase of the important part is started from here, where we have to put our experience, we have to put our like education background and all. So here I have put my experience in this way that I'm working as a senior data scientist or a data science consultant at Accenture. And when I joined like the location, then here we have to put a quick introduction, a quick description as well, so that the new people or the new recruiter or the person who want to reach you, they can understand that in what techniques or tools you already used, so that they can if they want to understand, they want to learn something from you, if they want to, they have some kind of opportunity for you, then they can directly offer to you, right? So I have mentioned that I involved in deployment and the deliveries for the human potential AI related solutions like AI, HR, transport, transformations, POCs and all. So I just mentioned that what tools and techniques I am working on and what I am working on. Then you need to you need to put all the experience here, right? If you have a multi, then you can put all the multiple experience here along with the description. So I'm just putting all the experience here, right? And I have some previous experiences as well, like Acoly Digital. So I have worked on these techniques. So I just put all the things, like I have created some kind of predictive modeling. I have created some kind of apps here. I have solving some kind of fintech problem. So I just put everything. Now, once you have done with your description part for the various jobs, anyhow, you need to put your description for various jobs. The main important part is here, again, we have to select the right keywords. So for the data science, we know the right keywords are like supervised learning, unsupervised learning. Firstly, you just need to go to the Google and search for the right keywords for your specific domain or your specific job. If you are a data scientist, then machine learning, supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement learning, deep learning, NLP, computer vision, these are going to be the right keywords for you. If you are a business analyst, then Power BI tools, communication skills or like a data science related skills, these are going to be our right keywords for you. So firstly, go and check the right keywords, what are the right keywords, what are the suitable keywords for you. Now the next part is here, we have to put our education here, right? So in education part, you can, if you want, then you can also upload your transcript and the certificate if you want. But if you are totally free to do that, but we have to give our explanation that what tools and techniques you have learned there. If I have learned data science, machine learning, supervised and unsupervised, artificial intelligence, data engineering tools like mining, data mining tools, statistical and predictive analytics or analysis I have learned. So I just put everything, you also do in the same manner. You need to put your career or education background in a such way, like a present, past, like that way. So I recently completed a degree diploma program. Then before that, I done my degree program. Before then, I have done my schooling kind of. So I just put in the same manner. And along with that, if you have done some kind of, if you got some kind of achievement, then you can also put here, right? That I have secured fourth rank at the IIT Roorkee for the Robo War or something, right? So you can also put your achievements here. Now, once you have completed your education, once you have completed with your job related stuff, then the next part is actually a licenses and the certification, if you've done any. So I have done many certifications. So we have to put a certifications along with the issued date of that certification. If there's any expiration date, then we also need to put there. And from where we have got the certification, that also we need to put. So I've done some LinkedIn certification, I have done some kind of Udemy certification, I have done some kind of AWS certification from Gate Learning, I have done some HackerRank certification, I have done some iNeuron certification. So what are the number of certifications you have done, you just need to put here. I have done some IBM certification. So you just need to put each and every certification which you think that is important for you, then you can directly put here along with the credentials and the issue date as well, right? Now post that, we have to put our volunteer experience. So I have volunteered I have been volunteering some of the places, so I just put there, right? I was a campus ambassador for IIT Guwahati, so I'm just putting that for what purpose I was there, and I was for what purpose I was a campus ambassador there, so I just put each and everything, right? Then the social worker I also put there, the marketing volunteer I also put there, that I have hosted a event of Oppo F3 launch and entertain people with the games and the technology. Then people directly focus on your portfolio or in your profile with your skills and endorsement. Now, what is these endorsement? If you are good in some kind of skills, if you are good in data science skill, or if you have put your skills here, so this is the pen where we have to add our skills. So I have added some of the skills. I have added various skills here, right? So these are my skills, these are my top skills like data science, machine learning and deep learning, and these are my industry knowledge skills like statistical data analysis, project management, business analysis, data modeling, AutoML, data mining, and so many tools and techniques skills are here like Tableau, Python and all. And I have some interpersonal skills as well like team leadership or team building kind of them. Some general or other skills like OpenCV, NLP, data engineering, wave scraping kind of. So I just put so many skills here, right? And this is the right way to showcase your skills here, so that you can make your own good portfolio. Then once you have done with your skill part, now you can ask to your connections, you can ask to your seniors, you can ask to your colleague, you can ask to your co-workers, you can ask to a person with whom you already worked or who already know you better. You can ask them to endorse yourself. Endorse yourself means that they are saying that you are highly skilled, medium skilled or low skilled in this skill, and they have worked with you in so and so project. Maybe they was your co-worker, they was your colleague, they was your he was your manager, or she was your a junior or something. So based on your connection, they can give you the endorsement here, right? And this endorsement definitely will help you to reach to the maximum connections and maximum thing, right? And if interviewer came to your profile, then they can also see this part, that you are skilled in these and these skills, and most of the people, they give you the endorsement that you have already skilled in this these skills. That means you are a good employee, or you are a good person to hire there. Then after this, you can also do some kind of skill assessment test here. Like you can pass like SQL assessment, Tableau, machine learning. So many skill assessment are there. These are going to be a weighted average, or these are going to be these are going to add some kind of weights in your profile, right? If you pass any kind of skill assessment test like a SQL, Python, these are going to be a added part, or it will definitely add some kind of weights. Now post that, you can ask for some kind of recommendations. These recommendations are something like these are the industry people or a co-working people or colleague, or maybe not in the same industry, maybe in the different industry, maybe these are your teachers, maybe these are your coaches, mentors. You can ask for a recommendations, that please write a recommendation based on my learning, based on my how I perform in a project. So you can ask for your co-working people for these recommendations. So these recommendations are very, very important, right? Because with the help of these recommendations, the people can see that, okay, you have recommended by so many people. That means you have worked, you have done a great job in this field from last some time. Similarly, as I have got some kind of recommendation that Pius is one of the versatile data science professional who can handle any phase of the data science project. His knowledge on machine learning, deep learning is outstanding. I have worked with Pius on one of the time series project, which proves that he can transform complex data, something like that. Again, Pius is an amazing professional who brings all the right skills and expertise in deep learning and creating out of box thinking like that. So I have so many recommendations here, right? So yeah, these recommendations definitely help you for increasing the visibility as well. Now if you want, then you can also put some kind of accomplishment, like you can put your projects, courses, publications, and the languages known. So I have put some 14 projects here, right? I have worked on some computer vision project, COVID project, some image-based project, some voice-based project. So I have put so many projects along with their description. So again, like anyhow, in LinkedIn, if you are putting something, that means we have to write down the description. That is very important, because description will definitely showcase that you did something. Just putting the heading, it will not show that you did that part. Maybe you have copied from the Kaggle, maybe you have copied from the Google, but if you put some kind of description there, that means that shows that you did that. So I just put so many projects. Then I have what are the number of courses. If you want, then you can also add, so these are the number of courses I have done. Then some publications I have, so I just put these are my some publications, and with a quick introduction. Then you can put your, like, I know two languages, English and Hindi, so I just mentioned that I know English and Hindi. And we already aware with the home, my network, these pen. So I'm not going to cover this. Yeah, so I have completed my first part, which is that how to build a LinkedIn and why it is important. So it is very important to understand how to build a good portfolio. Now we will focus into a second part of the video, which is how to post and publish and reach maximum views and grow more connections. So it is an art, right, to publish some things or to post something, right? Now I'll tell you how can we do that. So let us suppose I'll go to this post, right? This post I have published last year. So whenever we have to post something, so the post should be yours only, right? You are not going to copy from anywhere else. If you are copying from anywhere else, then you should provide the credit to that person that I have just copied from here, or you can write a quote that thanking to this person for the such post, something like that. So the love, so like it is an art to to write or publish a post where you can work on the attention of the people, that you can write something interesting, you can write something insightful, you can write something informative. So here I have just write one HR scenario for the interviews, that how interviews happened and something like that, with the two-way communication with the candidate in the interview. So here I'm just you can use right hashtags again, right? As interview is the right hashtag here. Resumes, I can use right hashtags. CEOs, CFOs, these are the right hashtags. So whenever you are just uploading or publishing any kind of post, don't use so many hashtags. We just need to use the right hashtags, which is actually important for that post, not that you are just randomly putting so many hashtags. That is not important. So this post went viral, and I got 247,000 views and 5,200 something likes and comments, something, right? So again, anyhow, you need to focus on the right hashtag, you need to focus on the attention of the people, you need to focus on the interesting part of the post and something like that. Apart from that, what you can do, if you have to upload some kind of images and our videos, if you want to publish some kind of this stuff, then you don't need to focus on this part, right? Sharing the URL. Rather than sharing the URL, just try to focus on providing the video, uploading the video directly, right? So apart from my post, we will also look in some other people's post. Yeah, like this. So this is very important, right? The very simple wording here, and four images are there, right? And with the help of these images, we can understand that what actually that person want to say with us, right? And similarly, we will look into some of other posts as well, which is done by some other people, like this, some of the best advices I have been given. So this is just a image based or a image message. Even though Ankur Baruku I just got, right? So seven investing apps are there, and he is also using some kind of hashtags, not so many, very less, but the right one. And if you want to share Ankit, like any person's post or something, then you can share in this way. Now again every time we have to use some kind of hashtags. Along with that, we have to focus on the engagement of the people, we have to focus on everything. Now this is one part of the second step or second part. Now the B part of this part, that how to reach to the maximum views and grow more connections. Now this is so here what we can do, we these are the posts which coming from the already existing connections, which connections we already have. So what we can do, we can comment, we can like the other connections thing, right? Like this, I have been learning from cloud, like let us suppose, yeah, some of the posts we can like this way, like okay, like this, yeah, I'm just liking this, that HRY should be hire you candidate now, you tell me why position is vacant or something, right? So I like this, and if you want, then you can also make some kind of comments here. So this is the way to make your engagement, this is the way to improve your engagement, right? So this is the one way to increase your engagement. Just engage with the post, engage with your already existing connections, maybe by liking, maybe by supporting, maybe by sharing the content, maybe by writing some kind of comment like this, like here. So you can't always say yes to everything. Yeah, this makes sense. So if you want, then you can also like write a comment, oh yeah, something. So I'm just looking for some good posts where I can make some kind of comment. Like how you can make a comment, I'll show you there. When you look at the Amazon seller score, okay. Okay, so yeah, this is a place where we can write some kind of comment, right? So people are liking this. Yeah, I also like that they are showing some data science related content with the chips. So this is very interesting post, and we can also learn some kind of fun fact here, like a consisting saddle shape of the Pringles is a mathematical known as a hyperbolic paraboloid. So kind of that, what we can do, what we can write some kind of comment, like it's really interesting. Right? So we can do this way. Even though if you want, then you can like others comments as well in order to increase the visibility of the network. Along with that, what you can do, if you are totally new in the LinkedIn, then you can go and search to the Loin community. So Loin is a community in the LinkedIn where people who are actually open for new opportunities. So you can mention your name with Loin. That means you are open for new opportunities, you are open for new connections, you are open for, like, anybody can connect you. You are open for those. So you can mention your name with Loin here. Otherwise, you can mention you are willing to join any group. You can also search for a Loin community, something like that. So people are mentioned that they are open for new opportunities, they are open for new connections, they are open for new people. So like this, you can mention that I am a Loin here, and I'm open for LinkedIn new opportunities. So this is the way to increase or make more connections day by day. But again, we have to focus on one part, that why we have to add with those people's, right? Even though if somebody checked your profile, if somebody looked into your profile, then you can directly go and connect with those people. But the main important part is here that we have to focus on the person which belongs to your domain only. Like if you are a data scientist, then machine learning engineer, data analyst, data scientist, junior data scientist, data science manager, senior manager, something like, or analytics people, they are a right audience for you, or they are the right connections for you. So just make a connection with those people. You don't need to make a connection with the fashion people, maybe with the retail people, marketing people or something. You don't need to make a connection with those, but in a starting time you can connect with those as well in order to share your thoughts, in order to understand them better, in order to increase your visibility in the LinkedIn. But after that, you have to focus on the right audience only. You have to focus on the right audience so that in future you will grow a very good network where you will have a right people with you. And if you are looking for a job, if you are looking for something, then you will definitely or easily you will get there. Now, we also need to understand the LinkedIn algorithm, that how this LinkedIn algorithm works in order to, like, whenever you are just publishing some kind of post and all. So we have like understood that how to publish and post something, then how this will go to the maximum reach, that also we need to understand, right? So this LinkedIn algorithm actually work into four manner. LinkedIn algo first, it is doing the content filtering. Now if somebody is posting something, right? So firstly, this LinkedIn algo work in the first step, it is checking some kind of spam words, some kind of discount related words, coupons or something, right? These are the spam words. So firstly LinkedIn algo check that whole post and something, and if you use some kind of discount, spam or like a coupon or hurry up something like words, then LinkedIn understand that this is kind of a spam message, this is kind of a spam post, and LinkedIn will not allow that post to reach to the other people. Now the second, after completing this content filtering, the LinkedIn algo will work on the testing of that post. So LinkedIn send this post to some set of the audience in order to check your engagement, in order to check your post, how your post is, and if is it good or not, or something, is it make sense or not, something like that. Then the third is, like, after testing, then it is actually giving us some kind of content scoring. If your content is good and liked by most of the people while the testing phase, it will give the high score. If it is not liked by the people, then it will give the low score based on the engagement done by the people. Then the fourth one is actually, and the final one is actually a real people assessment, right? Then once these three steps done, then the LinkedIn will share your post to the other peoples or the rest of the people who are there in your connections, in order to check the assessment of the people, that how they are engaged with your post and something. So we have to take care of some keywords. That's why I'm always focusing on the keywords, that keywords are very important. Anyhow, we have to focus on the keywords. If we are using the right keywords, that means we are good, we are in the right place, and we are using our right thing. Now I'm just jumping into a third part, right? How to increase the visibility in the network, which is very important, and for this part only people are looking for. So I will tell you here around 7 to 8 strategies to increase the network and everything, right? So and I will also help you to made some kind of changes in your settings to increase the networks and increase or grow the network as well. So how to increase visibility in the network and why we have to do that. Before jumping to how to increase, we have to understand why we want. Maybe some people want this to apply for a job. If you have a good engagement, then you will definitely get a good job. Maybe some want to sell something, maybe some want to purchase something, maybe some want to share their ideas, maybe some want to learn something, maybe some want to utilize some other stuff. Before this part, I also want to mention something, right, which is a very important part of your LinkedIn. If you are a premium member or not even, right, so we have a 1 month of free subscription, so just use your free subscription for learning some of the certifications or achieving some kind of certification. So just use your 1 month free subscription and achieve as many as certifications you can, or learn as many as you want, right? So it is a very good opportunity. You can learn so many things, so many topics, so many concepts or something. Along with that, also, if you want to apply for a job, so before jumping to how to reach a network, how to grow a network, I would like to say that how to apply for a job, that is also one part of this video. Like, let us suppose this is one profile. Now if I want to look if I want to apply, yeah, so what I can do, I can go to easy apply. So this is the thing, then I have to check that what is there, like title, data science mentor, instructor, some kind of role or responsibilities we have to understand, requirement understand, something like that, and then we can go and apply now. So here we, if you already uploaded your resume, then everything is here, you just need to submit here, that's it. All right. So this is the way to apply for a job. Now, we was discussing about how to increase visibility in the LinkedIn. So firstly, we have to, we can allow the mentions. Like anybody can mention you. It is very important, right? Now, I'll show you one example of here that how can people mention you. Okay. Mm-hmm. So people can mention you in order to increase their visibility. Along with that, if they want to reach to the maximum number of people, yeah, like this. So there's a person who mentioned me, right? So what they can do, they can like mention so many people. He mentioned me here, and with the help of that, this post is going to reach to my connections as well, my first degree connection, second and the third degree connections as well. So based on these tags, based on these mention, we can also reach to the maximum people. People can, but yeah, if you are not annoying to other people, and if you are mentioning every time, then he can also report you. So just mention the people if you know them. Otherwise, if you are mentioning the people you don't know, then they can also report you. That is not a good practice. Okay, so this is a like you can mention here. Now how to allow this mention, then you just need to go to the settings, and inside settings you just need to go to this part, like visibility, and post that you can change some kind of settings here, right? You can change your like who can discover with your phone number, everyone who can discover with your email number. You can allow this mention in the tag. You just need to go to the visibility of your LinkedIn activity, and you can allow this. So by allowing this, this will help you to reach to the maximum people. Allowing to the mentions, allowing to like who can share your posts, where like in which in what wall you can share the posts or something like that. These settings you must allow, which I was talking that these are the cheats and the settings which we have to change. Like we can change this way, ki what connection list, like who can see your last name, who can see your organizations and the interest, who can discover your profile, who can manage, who can like even share your posts and somewhere or something, right? So we can allow these kind of things. Along with that, you can also personalize your LinkedIn connection, as we discussed. You don't allow everyone to share, don't accept everyone's request here, right? So like if you see my network, so I have around 2105 connection requests pending. But yeah, don't allow everyone to like accept the connection request, because we have to focus on the area. We have to focus on the right people. We have to make a right kind of connections, right kind of network, where you can make LinkedIn is just kind of your neighborhood. It's kind of for your area, right? Where you have a people of your choice, where you have a people of your understanding, where you have a people of your like whatever the thought process of yours, they also have a same thought process. So this is your place, right? You either you can make everything like a zigzag. You are like accepting sending connections to every person, like maybe from other industries or something, right? Else you can work on yourself. You can also accept or send the request to the right person, which belongs to your domain only. Now the third part is actually exploring some kind of LinkedIn groups. So we have a various LinkedIn groups, like we have some if you go to the groups, right? So we have our various LinkedIn groups. You can be a part of some LinkedIn groups like data science community, data science for industrial engineers. We have so many groups are there. So just join the right group here. These groups also increase the visibility of your profile, as well as this will also increase to grow your connections. Then the fourth part is actually like invite engagement by posting often. So we have to post oftenly, right? As I post on daily basis, so you can also post on daily basis in order to reach to the right people. But yeah, posting the right things, posting your own thing, that is important. So if you are not able to post every day, so rather than posting every day, you can like someone's, you can like someone's profile or someone's post, or you can also comment someone's post or something. That is also a good way to reach to the maximum connections. Yeah, like this. So these are my so many things I have posted in daily basis. So you can do that way. Otherwise, you can like or comment in the others post. Then you can choose the right hashtags that we already mentioned that we have to choose the right hashtags. So like in this profile, I have used these hashtags because this profile related to the big data and something. So I am just using data science job, deep learning, AI analytics, data science, YouTube, resume, Python, cloud computing, Google analytics and something. So these are the right hashtags you must use. And apart from that, we also need to engage with the existing connections by liking or the comment. That is again an important part. Then the eighth step of reaching to the maximum connections is that we can use the right keywords in the profile, which we already mentioned from the starting. That right keywords anyhow very important. So every time we are able to see that right keywords are the thing to with the help of right keywords only we can reach to the maximum people, right? And if you want, then you can even if you want, if you have a right keywords, if you have everything updated, then even if somebody searches you in the Google, then they will find you in the top, right? So yeah, you will able to get me here even in the top. Even if you search here, then the first profile you found me is there, right? And even though if you search on the LinkedIn only, then you will again get me on the top. Then after that, some settings which we have to change, which we already discussed that what settings we have to change, like we have to allow some of the mentions, we have to allow some kind of profile settings, we have to allow some kind of post setting or something, right? These are the also important features which we have to work on. So hope I have covered all questions related to the how to reach to the maximum connections, how to reach everything, right? I have covered everything now. Yeah, thank you so much, and hope this LinkedIn video help you to reach to the maximum people. Please share your experience. If you found something interesting to my LinkedIn, you can directly text, you can directly share, message me in the LinkedIn that you found something interesting from this video, or if you are able to get some kind of more views, connection requests, or if you are able to increase your network, yeah, please let me know. Thank you so much. Bye bye.